probably where we started. Yeah, this was kind of their first.
It was the first need.
First need. Because at the Fab Lab, if people come in and they create so many incredibly creative things. They use the lasers and the 3D printers and the CNC machines and you know, just about every piece of tool that you would need is there in the lab. However, if for the lab to be sustainable, we can't continue to buy the product so people can use it. And also, the other thing is that if people purchase the product and they bring it in, sometimes what they purchase is actually toxic. And so, for example, if somebody buys the wrong ABS plastic or acrylic, sorry, not ABS plastic, acrylic, and they come in and they use the laser cutter, it actually creates a gas that kills you.
Yeah, for whoever's outside the window at the time.
Right. So, and those are things that not everybody would know. And so we wanted to kind of alleviate some of that, those issues. So we actually spent a lot of time working with the business office to develop our invoicing system. And so on the back end, we use PayPal. What has been great about this system, one is the customer service. So you can get some of our customers' custom services done. The other is the actual store. So if somebody wants to do custom products, which we do have a couple of vendors who actually put in orders for us to do metal business cards on the CNC machines. And then a lot of times we have, for example, Westside School is coming in there a couple of weeks to do a team building event, and they want to do dog heads. So that's where they would go into custom services. And then in the custom services, there's different elements that they can do. So what they can do is they can come in, and if they wanted to do advanced design services, it's completed by the faculty, advanced graphic design students, things like that, and they add it and they pay for it right away. And all of that, the funding and the money doesn't have to go through students, it doesn't need to go through faculty members, it immediately goes through PayPal, and it goes through to our PayPal account.
And one thing just to know, a lot of people get freaked out when you say PayPal, they go, I have to have a PayPal account. Our PayPal account handles the transaction, but they can securely just put in their credit card and pay that way. Mm-hmm. It's just that PayPal is handling it, so it is a secure transaction. Mm-hmm. We never see the card numbers.
They're just the merchants.
Yeah, and so we're doing it as a merchant. And some people are freaked out going, what do you mean? And I'm going, no, you don't have to have PayPal. They're just handling the sale for us.
It is a safety, it's actually a safety process for the college as well, because then we're not in the business of managing people's credit cards.
Mm-hmm. The other cool part is that it also creates an audit trail, so you can decide who's going to get a copy of a receipt saying that it happened. So it's not just me as the person that made it that knows there was a sale, but Tammy knows, Mike knows, I know, the business office knows. So there's a paper trail that if money isn't showing up or whatever, they would know right away.
Yeah. And it goes into an auxiliary account for the Fab Lab. And that auxiliary account is designed to manage basically the Fab Lab store and the products that we produce and those types of things, which helps us keep a little bit separate from the educational pieces of the things that we do. Does that make sense? Because we can't sell products. We can't as an educational institution. So there's a little bit of that.
And the old frustration was it used to go to the general fund, and we never saw it then for your thing. So we buy all of our supplies out of that fund. So the money going directly back into it, and you feel a whole lot better about it. It used to be, when I worked out in PIG, no matter how much we got back, we never saw it. So we were just always a negative. We were never seeing the positive. So this way, it really makes it easier to understand.
Here's the pictures on all of the products that people may need when they're working in the lab, and rather than us providing it for them, at a cost to the Fab Lab, they purchase it here.
and that way we can track it and purchase more, and that helps us build sustainability in the program. So that, you know, right now the Fab Lab is a sexy topic for grants, but that ebbs and flows, and so in 5 years, when it's no longer a sexy subject, then we still have some sustainability in keeping the Fab Lab open and keeping some of that STEM education that we're doing going, and also being active in the community.
A big thing to note is a store, though, can only do things that are tangible in specific amounts. One example you'll see in there that we used to do the filament, but the problem is that filament is measured by weight, and the weight's different for every job that you do. So if I had a 35-gram thing, I'd have to get the ad tag 35 times. So we have adjusted, because if you go into the treasury, you can do an invoice. And we haven't figured out how to get off the bill me later part of it. So the only ones that make invoices are the staff. They make an invoice for a person and send it to them right then and there, and then they go into PayPal and pay for it. But that invoice allows us to add stuff together. So like if they're doing vinyl and filament and stuff in one setting one night, they can, we add all those together before they walk out the door and they put their product they're paying for.
Another thing to note on the store, we allow the business office to tell us what to charge for that product. So that the business or MCC can recoup those incidental costs, because we have to pay taxes on those items. And then the other thing about this system is that it does allow us to keep track of what's being invoiced, how much product has been sold throughout the month, and those types of things. And our business office gets into our OrgSync site, and that's really, they balance our OrgSync site with the PayPal. So they use our treasury to balance